Hello guys, this is Warbrick here, yet again. Second day trying the voiceovers, and I think it works out well, so I'm going to keep doing it. Anyways, I'll be reviewing the M3A1 by Brickmania, one of their newer kits, I'd say. In the back here, it's got, in the video, when I was filming, it was very hard to get this open. It took me a few attempts, so I'll cut it out. And with the power of editing, there it is. There's not much in there, just random patch. I think it's for accuracy. It would lead to an engine bay, which is pretty cool, honestly. The tracks roll smoothly, I'd say. They do feel good when rolling them on carpet, but they will not roll on smooth surfaces. You need to put them on either rubber or a carpet. Anyways, on the back, there's a few shovels and tools. But then, I really like this minifig. This minifig has great printing, and I really like the classics. It also has that tanker hat. I don't know what it's called, but it looks really good. 3D printed Brickmania element. The hatch system, it's weird. It uses two hatches on a hinge system, and one has to be attached to the tank, and the other can be open, so you can have both open at the same time. But it works well since the turret is quite small. The gun elevation works smoothly, which is another feature that I really like. But one thing I have not seen on many kits is the amount of stickers. There is a big sticker sheet on this kit, which honestly is good since it brought down the price by a lot. And that's something I can respect. But you may think they're prints at first, but in person you can tell they're stickers. So that's basically it. I mean, it's a great kit by Brickmania, and I'll see you guys in the next one.